It's no secret that Mitch McConnell is an absolutely horrendous human being and a terrible legislator. The man has routinely, over a, 36-year career, has made sure that corporations are taken care of, that the wealthy elite get everything they want, and of course that the American public gets screwed over every single time. There is nobody worse than Mitch McConnell. Oh, and of course he's also responsible for packing our court systems all the way from district courts to the Supreme Court. So Mitch McConnell, in terms of who has done the most damage to this country, is right up there in the top five for the Republicans. Nevertheless, Mitch McConnell has not always been a loyal little Trumper, and so people are now wondering whether McConnell's going to retain his leadership position should Republicans take back the Senate in this year's midterms. One of the people who is already saying that maybe it's time for somebody else to step in is Republican Congressman Mo Brooks, who is currently running for a Senate seat in the state of Alabama. So he's in the House right now. He's running in a Republican primary for that Senate seat. For the record, he's not doing very well, but he has gotten Donald Trump's endorsement, which probably helps explain why he's not doing so well. But during an interview this week, Mo Brooks openly said that he's not sure Mitch McConnell can actually work with Donald Trump. So, you know, because of that, we got to start looking elsewhere. And let me read you the names on Mo Brooks' short list about who he would like to see replace Mitch McConnell. Ted Cruz, Ron Johnson, Rand Paul, Mike Lee, Josh Hawley. Any one of those people, Mo Brooks says, would likely be able to not only do the job, but also work hand in hand with Donald Trump. Because after all, isn't that the most important thing? No. I mean, obviously, anybody with a rational brain looks at this and says, no, that's not what needs to happen here. But that's what Mo Brooks wants to happen. Luckily, there's not a ton of Republicans in the Senate who are on board with Brooks's plan. And I say luckily, because think about it this way. As horrible as Mitch McConnell is, as destructive as his policies are, one thing you cannot say about Mitch McConnell is that he's a blind ideologue. Now, I know that sounds weird to say, and I'm sure people are already trying to hammer it out in the comments here. Listen, McConnell hates the Democrats. He wants them to fail. He's made it clear. He said it on camera. I get that. But he's not nuts, okay? He's not pushing the same kind of ass-backwards partisan attacks that people like Ted Cruz and Rand Paul and Josh Hawley are pushing. Mitch McConnell cares about legislating. Unfortunately, all the legislation he cares about pushing screws over the American public and benefits the wealthy elite. But take some of these other people, Ted Cruz or Rand Paul or even Josh Hawley, their policies would be the same. So you're not getting anything different in terms of that. What you do get different that is worse is that these people will do whatever it takes to appeal to the masses. If that means sucking up to Donald Trump and pushing far-right legislation, like banning books or jailing Dr. Fauci, they're going to do it. And that's the difference between the two. You know, your group of wackos and Mitch McConnell. Because again, to his credit, Mitch McConnell isn't wacko. He's just a horrible, horrible human being. And sometimes, unfortunately, we do have to make the choices between a horrible person and a horrible person who also has hints of craziness. And I'm sorry, but the lesser of two evils in that particular situation is in fact the horrible individual. Now, of course, there's a chance all of this is moot. Republicans don't take back the Senate this year, and all of these conversations mean nothing. I don't think right now that Mitch McConnell is in any danger of losing his leadership position. But what I would like to see happen is Republicans lose enough seats to where it doesn't matter who their leader is, they will be basically politically impotent in that Senate chamber. That is what we need to work towards. Because if Republicans take it back and they get their way, we're going to end up with somebody far worse than Mitch McConnell could ever dream of being.
This is Hattie. Patty wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.